A red giant, by definition, is a very large star of high luminosity and low surface temperature. Red giants are thought to be in a late stage of evolution when no hydrogen remains in the core to fuel nuclear fusion. Eventually, the sun is going to become a red giant. So we thought, why not get a head start and help you figure out what would happen if our sun was a red giant? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all those burning questions you may have. Today's question, what if our sun was a red giant? My name is Jared Bronstein, and before we get into this video, I want to know your thoughts. What do you think is going to happen when the sun really does expand? Let me know in the comments down below, and of course, share this video with a friend. I'd love to hear what they think as well. I'll be responding to some comments from a previous video at the end of this one, but for now, let's just get right into it. Now, before we answer the question, let's talk more about what a red giant actually is. So stars shine the way they do because they're converting hydrogen into helium in their core. This is called nuclear fusion, and it leads to a large buildup of helium in the core of the star. After the star uses all of its hydrogen fuel, it begins to collapse on itself. This is because the outward pressure of fusion balances with the inward pressure of gravity. But before the star collapses completely, the process heats up a shell of hydrogen around the star's core so it can support hydrogen fusion. When the nuclear fusion stops, gravity takes over and compresses the star. This leads to a huge temperature and energy increase, which expands the star anywhere from 100 million to 1 billion kilometers in diameter. In regards to the sun, it would be 100 to 1,000 times the size it currently is today. Now that the energy is spread out across a larger area, the temperature of the surface actually drops, and the color of the star changes to red or orange because of the change in temperature. So what is going to happen when our sun becomes a red giant? Well, it would expand and consume Mercury and Venus for sure. It would also reach Earth, but scientists aren't 100% sure whether or not Earth will be completely engulfed or if it will just orbit dangerously close to the sun. Either way, anything living in about 5 billion years or so when this is expected to happen will definitely die. The reason scientists can't confirm what would happen to the planet is because as the sun burns hydrogen, it loses mass, which causes planets to orbit further away. It's also very difficult for scientists to determine how planets will orbit in the next 5 to 6 billion years. But one thing is for sure, the sun is going to get way too close to the Earth, causing the oceans to literally boil. But how would this affect other planets? Well, it actually might make them habitable, because when stars morph into red giants, they change the entire system. This could possibly lead to other forms of life arising on planets currently on the outer solar system. After the expansion of the sun, they would be brought much closer. But this would only be for a period of time. Eventually, all red giants turn into much smaller, dimmer white dwarfs. In a sense, it's the corpse of the star. So to wrap up, what if our sun was a red giant? Well, it would destroy a handful of planets, possibly engulf Earth altogether, and if it didn't, it'd definitely destroy any living beings on the planet. It would also possibly bring new life to other planets in the outer solar system. But all of this won't happen for billions of years, so I wouldn't worry too much. And now it's the moment we've all been waiting for, when I respond to comments. In the video we did titled, What If You Spent a Week Underwater?, Christian Salas said, what if horror films had no music? That, my friend, is a great question that I think we should definitely cover. I've actually watched a horror movie on mute. I mean, obviously not the whole movie for an hour and a half, 2 hours, but if you mute a horror movie altogether, it's not scary at all. Even if you take the music out, it's kind of funny. Zero said, I read it as, what if you spent a week in your underwear? Well, if you did that, I mean, you'd probably just get a bad rash and have to go see the doctor. Matt Sedano said, this guy is fast. Well, Matt, I'll try to talk slower, I guess. You know, I'm just starting out here, so if you guys have any tips or tricks on how to improve or what you guys want to hear or don't want to hear, you know, in the sense of, am I talking too fast, too slow? You get what I'm trying to say. Let me know in the comments below. And that does it for this one, guys. As always, please drop us some comments with a question you want an answer to. Let me know your thoughts on this video, and be sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel so you guys never miss a video, and hit that bell notification so you can be the first to know when we answer the question you asked. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and until next time, keep questioning everything, my friends.